Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Alternate locations. Others, however, argue that Atlantis was not located on a now-submerged island near Gibraltar. Instead, they contend that it was actually on the island of Crete. These individuals argue that archaeological evidence suggests that in around 1500 BC an advanced civilization, the Minoans, was located there and was much like Plato's Atlantis. In particular, Plato said that the Atlanteans worshipped the bull, and the Minoans worshipped the bull as well. Another theory places Atlantis on the island of Thera, 60 miles, 97 kilometers, north of Crete, where a massive volcanic eruption struck in approximately 1625 BC. Archaeological expeditions have uncovered evidence of bull worship on Thera, and some archaeologists believe that it was once the center of the Minoan civilization. In his 1991 book, Unearthing Atlantis, An Archaeological Odyssey, Dr. Charles Pellegrino, an expert in crustaceology, paleontology, marine archaeology, and advanced rocketry, connects artifacts from this civilization to Atlantis mythology by showing how various archaeological discoveries fit in with Plato's descriptions of Atlantean objects and customs. Some people, however, argue that while Plato's descriptions were correct, he was wrong in saying that Atlantis was an island in the Atlantic Ocean. They believe that Atlantis was in a different ocean and/or was a continent instead of an island. A few people have suggested that Atlantis was located on the peaks of the Andes Mountains. Some think that after Atlantis, the ocean swallowed Atlantis, the civilization continued to exist in underwater caverns. Still others think Atlantis was swallowed by the land rather than the sea and still exists within caves deep beneath Earth's surface. One place commonly mentioned by such people is the area beneath the Great Sphinx in Egypt, perhaps at least partially inspired by Plato's reference to ancient Egypt. Extraterrestrials. This Egyptian connection has led some people to believe that the Atlanteans were actually extraterrestrials whose wisdom and technology enabled the ancient Egyptians to build their great pyramids and statues. Such people have theorized that Atlantis was actually a planet whose inhabitants settled on Earth after their own world was destroyed by a global nuclear war, environmental damage, or some other disaster. Others have suggested that Atlantis is an alien world within the center of a hollow Earth and that the former extraterrestrials who live in this world sometimes venture out to abduct and study human beings. People who subscribe to such theories often base their beliefs on descriptions of Atlantis provided by individuals who claim to have first-hand knowledge of the civilization. For example, 19th century psychic Helena Petrovna Blavatsky said that she knew what Atlantis was like because of her mental powers, while the faith healer and self-proclaimed prophet Edgar Cayce, 1877-1945, professed to know about Atlantis because in a past life he had lived on Atlantis. In 1977, a woman named J.Z. Knight from Tacoma, Washington, claimed that she was able to channel the spirit of an Atlantean warrior named Ramtha, and ever since then she has been transmitting his words about Atlantis, Lemuria, another legendary, lost world, and other subjects to paying audiences.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.